Today I have the great pleasure of introducing to the Pennsylvania House of Representatives one of Pennsylvania's native sons, the Honorable Reverend Congressman William H. Gray. Congressman Gray has had a lot of accomplishments in his life and has done a lot for humanity. And I'm very thankful that I can call him a friend, a mentor, and also a spiritual advisor. He has had major impacts on some of the decisions that I have made in my life. I can also call on him with some things people might consider trivial when I think it's very important. He's always there with a listening ear. He ran the United Negro College Fund for 14 years. In the entire history of the United States House of Representatives, he's the only African American that was the majority whip. He also head up the Budget Committee, which were positions that normally don't come to an African American or a person from Pennsylvania, but he knows how to negotiate with people. He understands the art of politics. He understands the need of all Americans, as well as others that live on other continents. At this time, I'd like to introduce my fellow representative, Curtis Thomas.
Gentlemen, Mr. Thomas from Philadelphia is recognized on the resolution.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. And let me thank my colleague, the Honorable Rosita Youngblood. I am overwhelmed, excited, and honored to stand here and welcome an icon of the 20th century, the Honorable William H. Gray III. Representative Youngblood mentioned a few things, but he was an icon of lawmaking. If you look at his history, he has provided some of the most progressive legislative proposals to go through the United States House of Representatives. As a negotiator, I have watched Congressman Gray deal with the Rwanda and other conflicts that was when he was called on by President William Jefferson Clinton. I know that there are more young people who are doctors, lawyers, teachers, navigators, and people from all walks of life are celebrating that today because of the contribution that he made to the Negro College Fund, as president of the Negro College Fund. And last but not least, we can celebrate the history of this icon because of the contributions that he has made to local, state, and federal legislative bodies. The first African American to sit in the Pennsylvania Senate. That foundation was laid by Honorable William H. Gray III, and I'm talking about the late Honorable Roxanne Jones, was the first African-American in the Pennsylvania Senate. In the city of Philadelphia, there are women serving in city council now, stellar stewards in a lawmaking body, the Honorable Marion B. Tasco, the Honorable Augusta A. Clark. And even if you look at this body, Pennsylvania Senate, and the Pennsylvania Senate, the Honorable Vincent Hughes, Democratic Chair of the Appropriations Committee, Pennsylvania Senate, the Honorable Dwight Evans, 90% of the African Americans that have come to the House and Senate had to come through, had to work with, and had to get the support of Honorable William H. Gray III. So he is an icon in lawmaking. He's an icon in sending good people to legislative bodies at the local, state, and federal level. Icon in resolving conflicts that we didn't know which way to turn. And last but not least, the people of South Africa are enjoying freedom today like you and I have never known. And it exists because it was Congressman William H. Grady III that stood up and did what he needed to do to help bring an end to apartheid in South Africa. South Africa is a new country today because of the contribution that he made. So, Mr. Speaker, it is my honor to welcome, introduce, and present to this body the Honorable William H. Gray III. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.
Question is, will the House adopt the resolution? Those in favor of the resolution will vote aye. Those opposed, nay. The members will proceed to vote. Return to leave of absence and recognize the Minority Caucus Chairman requests a leave of absence for the gentleman, Mr. Gerber, from Montgomery County for the remainder of the day without objection. The leave will be granted. Of all the members voted, clerk will record the vote. On the resolution, the yeas are 194, the nays zero. The resolution is adopted. And with that, I would like to offer the dais to Mr. Gray for a few remarks in recognition of his contributions to this state and this country. Mr. Gray.
Mr. Speaker, officers and members of this great legislative body, it is indeed a great honor for me to stand here and hear all of those wonderful things said about me. I only wish my wife was here. I've been trying for years to convince her that I'm not a bad person, and with your help, maybe I'll have a better luck next week. But I am indeed honored, by all of you, but especially by Rosita Youngblood, Representative, and Clarence Thomas for their efforts in this great honor. But also, I am honored that you would do something like this because of who you are. You are the public servants of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. You are the ones who shape the policy that will move this great state forward. You are the ones that mend the broken places of our society. And I'm just honored to be here with you and to receive from you this honor and to say to you, there's no greater work than the work that you do in serving the public of our great state. And so, Mr. Speaker, let me say thank you to all of the members of this great body and wish you well as you continue to build a great Commonwealth.